The Narendra Modi government poses a threat to the country's democracy and constitution. That's what Dalit leader Jignesh Mevani said today at a youth rally in Delhi, for which the Delhi police in fact had refused permission. The newly elected MLA from Gujarat termed the refusal to grant permission to the Hunkar rally as an example of the Gujarat model of politics. The rally was demanding the release of the Dalit outfit Bhim Army founder Chandrasekhar Azad. They were also talking about issues like education, employment and gender justice. However, the turnout wasn't too great.
इतनी बात रखने का यदि एक इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव को भी अधिकार नहीं तो यही वो गुजरात मॉडल है। और मोदी जी हम आप ही के गुजरात के हैं और विधायक भी हैं हम तो और हमें मालूम है हमारे असेंबली में जाने के चलते आपको बहुत सी फाइलें जलानी पड़ी है और सारे वो ब्यूरोक्रेट जितने सालों तक बोल नहीं पा रहे थे वो सारी करप्शन की फाइलें हमारे पास आने वाली है हमको मालूम है लेकिन
जिग्नेश मेवानी Dalit student leader and recently elected MLA from Gujarat, taking on the central government and Prime Minister Modi. He was denied permission to hold a rally in Mumbai. But today, he along with a young group of student leaders made certain they held their rally in Delhi. The day-long youth Hunkar rally of almost 2,000 people was surrounded by nearly 15,000 security personnel, armed with water cannons, tear gas and wearing riot gear.
Behind me are 49 groups who have come together, but they're all strung by this one thread. They are young, they come from different parts of the country, from different castes, but demanding one thing: end atrocities against Dalits and Muslim and women. Also, they demand employment for the youth.
They also want Chandrasekhar Azad, the founder of the Dalit group Bhim Army, to be released. Amongst those participating in the rally is 23-year-old Pooja Shukla from Lucknow. She spent a month in jail for showing black flags to CM Yogi Adityanath, which stopped his contingent for 10 minutes right outside the Lucknow University.
हमारे फंड के पैसे को मतलब हमारे एकेडमिक्स के फंड को वो आरएसएस के प्रोग्राम में यूज कर रहे हैं लगातार हमारे यहाँ फी हाइक हो रहा है
Another protester, 34-year-old Manoj Manzil, had to spend 19 months behind bars. In Jaunpur, Bihar, where Manoj comes from, he faces 18 FIRs for demanding clean classrooms for students.
फ्लोराइड को भी एफआईआर करके और वो बोलते हैं कि हम उठा लेंगे और उठा उठा करके जो महिलाओं के साथ जो होता है वो यौन हिंसा होता है वो भी हम तुम्हारे साथ करेंगे
The rally that started with great vigor, however, started to thin out, and by the evening there were many empty chairs. But as Kanhaiya said, they had what mattered.
हमारे पास भीड़ नहीं है, मैं कह रहा हूँ क्या करने आने वाले हैं? हेलो, हमारे पास भीड़ नहीं है।
The banners are down, the stage is wrapped up. The first ever Yuva rally today saw less than expected crowd of just 2,000 out of the expected 5,000. They managed to keep violence at bay, but with that, the crowds went away as well. The big question now in front of the Yuva leaders is, will they manage to keep a unified front? And will this momentum keep on? With cameraperson Fahad, Sonal Mehrotra Kapoor, NDTV.
Well, joining us first on the program tonight is Jignesh Mevani. And Jignesh, let me begin by asking you, you said at the rally that this was the Gujarat model of politics, that you didn't get permission by the Delhi police to hold the rally, but ultimately you did it and you were able to go ahead and make your speeches.
हाँ हमारा सबसे पहले यही कहना है कि why should an elected representative or any citizen in this country be denied the permission for carrying out a peaceful march or peaceful rally, just seeking the assurance of social justice, seeking the release and some sort of relief for Bhim Army's chief. चंद्रशेखर आजाद रावण डिमांडिंग 2 crore जॉब्स फॉर द यूथ ऑफ दिस कंट्री, हम कौन से डिमांड, यही तो डिमांड कर रहे थे, तो रैली का परमिशन क्यों ना मिले भाई, हमारा तो यही सवाल है। कल दिल्ली पुलिस की किसी आला अधिकारी ने, उच्च अधिकारी ने एक ट्वीट भी किया दैट वी आर नॉट गिविंग पुलिस परमिशन। कुछ चैनल ने लगातार कैंपेन चलाया कि जिग्नेश मेवाणी की रैली को परमिशन नहीं, परमिशन नहीं, परमिशन नहीं, उसके बावजूद 2500 से 3000 लोग वहां पर उमटे, ये बहुत बड़ी पॉजिटिव बात है। और यही कहूंगा आपके शो में, अभी तो ये अंगड़ाई है, आगे और लड़ाई है।
आपने अभी कहा कि 2500 से 3000 लोग थे, ये आपका कहना है, लेकिन जो हमारे रिपोर्टर ने वहां पे देखा जिग्नेश, इट वॉजेंट अ वेरी ग्रेट टर्न आउट, मतलब मॉडेस्ट टर्न आउट था। और कुछ फोटोग्राफ्स भी सर्कुलेट हुई हैं सोशल मीडिया पे, कुछ फुटेज भी है, वो कुर्सियां खाली हैं। कन्हैया ने अपने स्पीच में कहा कि हाँ वी डोंट हैव क्राउड्स बट वी हैव पीपल हु आर हियर टू सपोर्ट अस। हैज दैट बीन अ डिसअपॉइंटमेंट फॉर यू? वॉज इट अंडरवेलमिंग दैट दिस, यू नो, इट वॉजेंट अ ह्यूज क्राउड लाइक यू मे हैव वॉन्टेड?
नो, I am very honestly speaking, I am more than satisfied, we all are more than satisfied and happy that me, Shaila, Kanaiya, Prashant Bhushan, team members from the Swaraj India, Akhil Gogoi, Manoj Manjil from Bihar, from the various parts of the people came together, set together, set out the agenda that we stand for love, not for violence. We stand for constitutional values of creating a secular socialist democracy, not a Hindu Rashtra. तो ये सारे लोगों का एक साथ आना, और 2500 लोग भी पहले अटेम्प्ट में बाहर आए पुलिस के सारे एफर्ट्स के बावजूद, बहुत सी गाड़ियों को रोका गया, कैंपेन चला कुछ मेनस्ट्रीम के चैनल्स के द्वारा कि परमिशन नहीं ही मिलने वाला, पुलिस ने भी ट्वीट किया कि परमिशन नहीं दे रहे, उन सबके बावजूद ये 2-3 हजार जो लोग आए, आई एम मोर देन हैप्पी एंड सेटिस्फाइड। महत्व की बात है कि साथ में मिलकर हम लोगों ने ठोस रूप से ये कहा कि हम साथ में ही रहेंगे, 2 crore युवा को रोजगार मिले उस बात को लेकर पूरे देश में कैंपेन करेंगे, भीम आर्मी के साथ ही चंद्रशेखर आजाद को हर कीमत पे रिहा किया जाए, जल्दी रिहा किया जाए, सोशल जस्टिस को एंश्योर किया जाए। ये अलग अलग विचार में मानने वाले युवा देश के अलग अलग कोनों में से एक साथ पाकर ये बात रखे, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन उसके ट्रू स्पिरिट में इम्प्लीमेंट हो, ये बात रखे, मेरे लिए बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है।
लेकिन जिग्नेश, आप मुझे ये बताइए कि क्या कुछ क्रिटिसिज्म है कि somebody लाइक यू, even though you won with such a big margin in Gujarat, ki you might be a temporary phenomenon, ki you don't have the staying power for staying the course in Indian politics. Those who say that about you, aap unhe kya kahenge? Are you a long-term leader who is a grassroots leader who is here to stay? Or as they say, someone who's been given this revolutionary tag, but that it's a temporary tag. Matlab, aap kya kahenge unko, jo aapke critics hain?
क्रिटिक्स लग रहा है कि ज्योतिष शास्त्र का अभ्यास आजकल कर रहे हैं, उनको मैं कुछ नहीं कहूंगा, आई डिस्कार्ड बाय क्रिटिक्स बाय सिंपली कॉलिंग देम क्रिटिक्स। लेकिन एक बात ठोस रूप से कहना चाहेंगे कि जिस प्रकार से ऊना के वक्त पे भी हम लोगों को इसी तरह से क्रिटिसाइज किया जा रहा था, तो 2 दिन के लिए खड़े हुए फिर सो जाएंगे, ऐसा नहीं हुआ ना। ऊना से लेकर अब तक मोर्चा संभाले हुए, जमकर लड़ाई लड़ रहे, दलितों के लिए जमीन की लड़ाई भी लड़े हैं, सड़कों पर उतरे, संघर्ष किया है, चुनाव भी जीत के दिखाया, इलेक्टोरली भी चीजों को एक्सप्लोर करके दिखाया सक्सेसफुली। तो आने वाले दिनों में लड़ाई को और भी एक्सपांड करेंगे, एक्सटेंड करेंगे, जितने भी प्रोग्रेसिव लोग हैं, जितने भी आंबेडकर, सबके साथ में मिलकर ये संघर्ष को आने वाले दिनों में और भी तेज करेंगे। आज किसी को कुछ भी प्रेडिक्ट करना वो करे, हमको कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है।
एक और क्रिटिसिज्म है, और ये वो ये है कि द पीपल यू आर शेयरिंग अ स्टेज विद नाउ, क्रिटिसिज्म ये है कि इफ यू आर गोइंग टू कन्फाइन योर सेल्फ टू वॉट इज कॉल्ड द JNU ब्रांड ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स विद पीपल लाइक उमर खालिद एंड यू नो दैट डजंट मीन इट्स नेसेसरली रॉन्ग, बट ये आपके क्रिटिक्स कह रहे हैं दैट यू आर कन्फाइनिंग योर सेल्फ टू अ वेरी नैरो पोलिटिकल स्पेस, दैट यू नीड टू वाइडन योर पोलिटिकल स्पेस टू गो बियॉन्ड उमर खालिद एंड कन्हैया कुमार।
ये स्कोप को वाइडन करने के लिए तो आज हमारे लिए स्टेज पे इतने सारे युवा साथी थे, हम लगातार हर दिन एफर्ट करेंगे कि जितने भी साथियों को हमारे साथ जोड़कर लड़ाई को लड़ पाए उन सभी को जोड़ने की कोशिश करेंगे, जो लोग हमको अपने साथ जोड़ना चाहते हैं उनके सभी के साथ भी जाएंगे, साथ साथ गुजरात में भी धीरे धीरे हमारे पूरे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को स्ट्रेंथन करेंगे, उनकी जड़ों को मजबूत करेंगे, एक्सपांड करेंगे। वड़गांव में हमको एक वड़गांव विकास मॉडल, वड़गांव को विकास के मॉडल के तौर पर हम लोगों को पेश करना है, तो वड़गाम में भी काम करेंगे जमकर, और उम्मीद यही है कि न केवल दलितों के सवाल को लेकर, लेकिन गुजरात में आशा वर्कर है, आंगनवाड़ी की बहनें हैं, किसान है, मजदूर है, युवा वर्ग के जो सवाल है, खास करके चिकित्सा का सवाल है, पब्लिक हेल्थ का और एजुकेशन के, इन सारे सवालों को आने वाले दिनों में पूरे गुजरात में, पूरे वड़गांव में उठाएंगे, नेशनल भी इन सभी को, इन सभी मुद्दों को, सभी सवालों को उठाएंगे, तो धीरे धीरे जमकर एक्सपांड हो गए।
जिग्नेश, मेरा आखिरी सवाल आपसे ये है कि क्या
चीजें आज ही हो जाए, ऐसा क्यों जरूरी है?
नहीं,
इतना प्यार
वो बात सही है,
बहुत बड़ी बात है,
वो बात सही है। मेरा आखिरी सवाल आपसे ये है कि क्या आप युवा नेता हैं कि दलित नेता हैं?
हम दलित समाज में पैदा हुए हैं, लेकिन केवल दलित समाज के सवालों के साथ ही हमारा सरोकार नहीं रहा, हमने सफाई कर्मियों के मुद्दे को लेकर भी आंदोलन किए। मेरे पब्लिक लाइफ की शुरुआत, उसका आरंभ गुजरात के किसानों की आत्महत्या के मुद्दों के साथ हुआ। गुजरात में गुजरात इंडस्ट्रियल सिक्योरिटी फोर्स सोसाइटी के जो जवान हैं, उनको हमने यूनियनाइज किया है, लेप्रसी के पेशेंट्स के लिए काम किया है, विडो मेन के विडो पेंशन के सवाल को लेकर काम किया है, और आने वाले दिनों में भी जाति और धर्म से ऊपर उठ के युवा अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट के मुद्दे पर साथ है, उसके लिए नेशन वाइड कैंपेन करेंगे। तो दलित समाज में पैदा हुए हैं, लेकिन युवा नेता जरूर है।
Alright, Jignesh Mevani, thanks very much for joining us this evening. Jignesh Mevani there saying that I've definitely been born a Dalit, but I'm very much a youth leader in this country. Well, let's take that to our panel this evening. We have Professor Vivek Kumar from JNU. Sorry about that little dig at JNU a couple of minutes ago. Shivam Vij, journalist and columnist joining us here. Professor Rakesh Sinha of the RSS is with us, and Monica Arora, who's an advocate with the Supreme Court. Pawan Khera of the Congress also joining us today. Let me take this question to Shivam first. It's interesting, this whole phenomenon of Jignesh Mevani. Even you reported on Gujarat yourself, Shivam. I mean, a lot of people were dismissive of some of these young leaders, including Jignesh, and I think he surprised everyone with his margin of victory at that time. But I come to the fundamental question. Is this sort of revolutionary youth icon leader tag a bit of an exaggeration, or is it too early to say? Or does he represent something much stronger, something that we're not seeing?
The exaggeration, firstly, is in the margin of his victory, because had the Congress not given a Congress stronghold seat away to Jignesh, he would not have won, right? Congress did not put up a candidate there. He said, I will contest as an independent, not join as in the Congress party. And that's why he's won. Alone, without support of the Congress, he would not have won that seat. Having said that, I think this phenomena that we've been seeing for some time, be it Bhim Army or Jignesh or Hardik or Kanhaiya Kumar, this phenomena is an assertion of youth voices who are not finding space in mainstream politics, even in the amongst the opposition parties. I mean, today Jignesh Mevani appears to be a bigger Dalit politician than Mayawati, and the question is, where is Mayawati, where is the BSP? Why is it?
She may not be on TV, but that doesn't mean she's not necessarily making a revival on the ground.
But you know, the point is that the BSP has been declining electorally. When BSP was very big, when Mayawati had formed government on her own, UP, a lot of Dalits felt they had a voice in politics. This is people, a lot of young people feeling voiceless, and that these rallies, these leaders and assertion are a reflection of that feeling that mainstream politics does not have space for our voice.
Professor Sinha, you were shaking your head many times when Jignesh was speaking, but what Shivam is saying, that they represent young people who are feeling voiceless, isn't that something that should concern the government and all political mainstream parties, as Shivam is saying?
No, I would begin with this fact that there is a huge discrimination with Dalits all over the country, and caste feudalism is still in operation. That is the fact. And this responsibility goes to all political parties and political system, and also social structure, that is still after the independence of seven decades of independence, Dalit women, Dalit children, Dalit educated people are victim of in so many ways, not merely physical but also sometimes mental. This is the fact. This fact should be accepted. If anybody doesn't accept this fact, this means he's trying to do harm as much as other reactionaries are doing. But at the same time, I'm telling you that Jignesh is in hurry to hijack the Dalit leadership. That is very clear. The way he made a remark about the Baba Saheb Ambedkar, he has a right to make a remark, critical remark about Baba Saheb Ambedkar. I cannot stop anybody. And that was not much contemptuous. But his remark has shown that he is in hurry to hijack the Dalit leadership, and he is also trying to shift the Dalit discourse. Earlier, the Dalit discourse has a disagreement with the mainstream political party, whether it is a left, right, or centrist. They have disagreement on certain issues. He is shifting from disagreement to disaffection. This disaffection is creating a polarizing ground for the Breaking India Brigade. Kanhaiya Kumar, Omar Khalid, these are the agents of disaffection. They are creating disaffection against politics, disaffection against mainstream political party, disaffection against India, disaffection against the military. So these agents, this is my point of view, Nidhi. I am not with a contempt, I am telling you. One can disagree 100% with me. But these agents of disaffection cannot become the Dalit leaders. As far as Mayawati is concerned, I have 100% many disagreements with Mayawati ji, but I can tell you that. Mayawati ji, one leader who had experimented in the past by expanding Dalit horizon and Sarvajan experiment, giving 180 seats to the Brahmins. That was a failure on the part of the mainstream political party not to utilize that opportunity to end the binary. We should always not talk in debate in terms of political party. Just last man, that was an opportunity to end the binary. Which opportunity was missed?
Let me ask Professor Vivek Kumar about that. Is Jignesh in a hurry to hijack the Dalit leadership? What, according to you, does someone like him represent? And not just him. I mean, this rise of Hardik Patel, Alpesh. I mean, is this, as Shivam is saying, about young people who are feeling voiceless and now are channeling their anger on various issues that affect their communities through these young men?
Nidhi, I think one should look India not as if that it lives only in contemporaneity. I think there is a trend. If you trace, even from very beginning, we had a tradition of young Turks. You can begin with 1960s, when you had Morarji Desai, when you had Ramdhari, and then you had actually young Turk like Chandrasekhar, who came out of Congress and broke. 1970s throws Sanjay Gandhi. 1980s again. 1970s we had in Maharashtra, very vibrant Dalit leadership in Namdev Dhasal, Raja Dhale, Ramdas Athavale, they all came and they were actually formed a political party. 1972, Dalit Panther was born. 1980s, we have seen again, even with Rajiv Gandhi. 2000, we were seeing actually Congress having a great brigade from Sachin Pilot to Jyotiraditya Sindhya. So India has this habit of throwing up young Turks every 10 years. That's what actually my reading is. So I don't see that it is something very new phenomena. The new phenomena is they are getting more exposure because of the media, because of the social media. But at the grassroots, I have yet to see that they can garner a vibrant support. I do not see any vibrant support coming and agitation being called as movement as what we did during Anna Brigade. Anna came with agitation, we called it as a movement. And where is that movement? So we should not be in so hurry that actually this is a movement. Mm-hmm. First of all, thing is that it is only an agitational level. Second thing, a movement endures with ideology, with actually leadership, as well as one organization. Where is that? Again, you will like 1970s, a leadership was given by octogenarian, and where is that? Total revolution became total confusion. Where is that organization?
So you're saying it's too early to label it.
My problem is that movement. You are up against 93-year-old organization called RSS. Yeah. If you really are against it, 1980s BJP is born, 8.8 crore membership. What are you doing? You are actually fighting with that. It is just like firefighting. So let the organizations match organization, strength by strength. Then and then only, I think we are fighting a really long-term battle. Otherwise, there will be again a fiasco.
Okay, well, Pawan Khera, your thoughts on that, the Congress's thoughts on that, with Professor Kumar there being very blunt in his assessment of this, that he doesn't see this as something that will stay the long-term course unless there is a leadership, unless there is a plan. What do you think, Pawan?
No, I don't really differ with what Professor Kumar said, and it's good analysis on his part, but we need to deconstruct these voices that come out from various parts of the country over the last 2-3 years. The room for dissent, Nidhi, is increasingly getting smaller and smaller, especially under this dispensation. You cannot question this government. You cannot question the Prime Minister. The moment you do that, you will be labeled as anti-national. No, why are they afraid of questions? You don't want to answer? Fair enough, that's your prerogative. Now the same Jignesh Mevani, who you keep calling anti-national, has taken the oath of the Constitution of India when he won the election as an MLA. Now he is in mainstream politics, we'll have to accept him. You cannot ask him not to have a dharna or a pradarshan. Why are you scared of a dharna pradarshan in Delhi? ORP, what did you do? You lathi charge those men and women sitting there in the cold winter nights of in Delhi. You removed them. You did the same with the Anganwadi workers again in Delhi. Why is Delhi afraid of dissent? Why are they so insecure? Please the allow part,
the all party
kinds
which
of
imposed emergency.
At
I am happy that the party which imposed emergency snatched all fundamental rights.
Now
it's for democracy. I am really happy. The mutation of the Congress.
चलाइए आप कहाँ राजनीति में कूद रहे हैं आप आपके बस की नहीं है राजनीति
we were the people who were the people who liberated India from the emergency
पहले उसको register कराइए
have you forgotten
आप लोग अंग्रेजों को बुला
के Supreme Court just said had there not been RSS India would not have been liberated from the emergency this is the KT Thomas retired judge of the Supreme Court Pawan Khera not me
once we've gone off topic Pawan are you saying
भाषण
दे दिया वो एंटी नेशनल हो
अरे राहुल गांधी क्या करने गए थे सत्यनारायण भगवान की पूजा करने गए थे राहुल गांधी सोन सॉलिडेरिटी
कनाडा में खड़े भैया
कुमार अंदर
गाली देते हैं
भारत के दस टुकड़े होंगे राहुल गांधी वो देर You are not RSS, the Satyanarayan
Bhagwan Puja. One second. Let's just 1 second. Press the pause button here.
You have no locus standi, no credibility.
Pawan, the point is, are you saying that people like Jignesh, Alpesh, Hardik, they represent what? A young India or a certain section of young India that wants to dissent and feels that it can do it through them? Do you think that they have an appeal that cuts across caste?
Nidhi, they represent the restless India. And why is India restless? Now, this government, political parties, not just the government, all of us need to address the restlessness of the youth in this country. Why is there restlessness? Why is there anger? There is anger because of 2-3 reasons. And I can't simplify it in just a 30-minute show. But you promise jobs, you don't give them jobs. And if they question you, say you label them anti-national.
He considers
all
the
Dalits
problems.
Feel that they are being. Look at what's happening in Una. Mr. Rakesh Sinha should be ashamed of the so-called Hindutva brigade of RSS. Una ke Dalit Buddhism ko adopt kar rahe hain Rakesh Sinha sahab April ki 14 tarikh ko. Aap log ghar wapsi karane ka theka lete hain. Aap ko Hinduon ko dhakka mar rahe hain.
May I come in here please?
Aap hote hue Hindu Buddhist ban
Maharashtra you know. Ye
sharmnak baat hai RSS ki. Nagpur ka chhanda us din niche hona chahiye. Nagpur ka chhanda us din aapko niche kar dena chahiye. Aap ko shok manana chahiye. Aap Hinduon ko dhakka mar rahe hain. Pehli baar nahi hua.
Let me ask Monica Arora, who's very nicely and patiently sitting there and listening to this. Monica Arora, your sort of a take on this and what we're seeing. Are we seeing these young men representing a restless India, as Pawan says?
Very interesting debate, Nidhi. Nidhi, firstly, the topic of this debate was new youth power, and they're talking of just love, love and love. But do we see that this was the same Hate India Brigade on the stage which said Bharat tere tukde honge, Bharat ki barbadi tak jang rahegi? Is this the love for India they are stating, they're professing? Then thereafter, they talk and they support terrorists like Yaqub Memon openly. And they term army as assaulters and rapists. Is this the love for the army they are supporting? Then they all said marginalized sections get together with Muslims. The anti-Hindu stand which they have taken at the rally. Is this the love towards Hinduism they are supporting? I'm sorry. And people did not turn up. They stated there were 42 organizations organizing this rally. And there were hardly about 300, 400 people there. People have rejected their casteist politics. People have rejected their communal politics. People have rejected their hate politics. That's why, though they do not represent restless India. Nobody came to listen to them. They represent the, they are the allies of the Congress. Popular Front of India admittedly has funded Jignesh Mevani in his election campaign. He admits to that. Congress has supported him. Aam Aadmi Party has supported him. All these forces together in their hate campaign against India and Hindus, still they could not muster people. And let me tell you, if they could not have a rally in Delhi, it was because of National Green Tribunal. It was not because of Modi government. National Green Tribunal stated, no bhashan, no dharna pradarshan, no loudspeakers. It is a rally-like zone. If you want rallies, have them elsewhere. Have them in Ramla Maidan. So I say, Delhi Ice have stated, shame on this Hate India Brigade today. And all those people who support them.
Monica Arora saying there that this is a gathering basically of what she sees as anti-national, anti-Hindu people.
Nidhi, I don't want to utter a particular word for this lady, but she represents scoundrels, let's put it that way. And patriotism and communalism are the two last resorts of scoundrels. Why are they afraid? Come out. Give us the figures. Aapne 2 crore ki naukriyon ka vaada kiya tha, kya hua? What's happening in Una? What's happening in Saharanpur? Why is there so much of restlessness and anger? Why are Muslims being targeted? Why do you go and kill Akhlaq and not one word is uttered by the Prime Minister? On the contrary, a minister of the Union Cabinet goes to attend the funeral of Akhlaq's killer,
about
wraps a tricolor on his body.
You will not please, I didn't interrupt.
Have the decency not to interrupt.
Karnataka,
I am not addressing you and please don't interrupt. This whataboutery, Nidhi, this whataboutery is what is causing this restlessness.
Please don't.
She has answered my question. This is the whataboutery which is disturbing this country.
Why
aapke paas samasyaon ka samadhan nahi hai, na hoga. Aapke paas sirf aur sirf chunav jeetne ki obsession hai, bhale desh ki atma haar jaye, bhale desh haar jaye. You may win elections but you are losing this country. You are losing the spirit of this country. You are losing the soul of this country.
Let me get Shivam Medhi into this.
People will not forgive you for this.
Pavan and Monica, 1 second.
For all I care.
Please don't. And today who's also been borrowing sly smiles on the side. Shivam.
Yes,
okay,
sir, no.
One second, guys. Yeah. Shivam Vij, go ahead.
I think it's very simple. If you look at these incidents over the past couple of years, Rohit Vemula, Una, the Thakur Dalit violence in Saharanpur, then recently Bhima Koregaon, the attack on Dalits, there's a consistent pattern of Hindutva forces being involved in violent attacks on Dalits, be it in the name of Gauraksha, be it in the name of student activism or some other excuse. So what we are seeing here is not the Break India Brigade, it's the Broken India Brigade. These are reflections of an India that is being broken by forces of hate, and that is being reflected. I don't see what is the problem.
No, but what
why don't you talk about the BSF Jawan, Dalip Mandal, who belonged to the lower caste, who was killed while he was stopping the illegal slaughter of cows?
Because that cannot be an excuse to kill Dalits in Bhima Koregaon. Madam, that cannot be an excuse to attack Dalits in Bhima Koregaon. Why are your friends killing Dalits in Bhima Koregaon, in Saharanpur, in Una? Will you say sorry for Rohit Vemula?
Do not talk about only the Naxals and the communists and others.
You see, people, you don't like our Naxals, that's very easy. You know,
what I promise. Be reasonable, please.
What
please be reasonable.
Look who's talking about reason.
No,
the Constitution gives them equal rights.
So when you talk about Una, please, why don't you talk about Dilip Mandal, the BSF
Jawan? No, again, we're getting into whataboutery. I mean, one wrong doesn't justify another wrong.
Does not?
Professor Sinha had a question for Pavan Khera. One second, Pavan.
Nidhi,
he had a question for you.
Mr. Khera.
Absolutely.
Mr. Khera.
Talk about all the wrongs.
Okay, ma'am. Just one second.
Mr. Khera, you are talking of the restless India. We all are part of, if India is restless, then we can be part of the restless India. Is this restless India product of 3 years after 2014? Or this restlessness comes in 6 decades of the rule, then still untouchability prevails in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu and Kerala and North India. Still, there is a discrimination with Dalits, and for Shivam, the killing in the Una and beating of Dalits, we are the first to condemn. We are first to reach the site, and these are the caste casteist feudal lords, and that's why I said RSS has been doing work at the ground. Last word. You have locked the Harjan Sevak Sangh, which was founded by Mahatma Gandhi. But we have unlocked the Harjan Sevak Sangh. We have created many organizations all over the country. One of the Samajik Samrasta Manch. We are doing on the ground. We are for constructive critical work.
Vivek Kumar to give the last comment. Yeah, go ahead, Pawan.
निधि, ये बार बार समरसता की बात करते हैं, समता की बात कभी नहीं सुनेंगे आप आरएसएस के।
You don't understand the meaning of समरसता।
इनका बता दीजिए सर, इनका एक प्रमुख बता दीजिए जो आरएसएस का दलित हुआ हो। ये हमें भाषण दे रहे हैं दलित के बारे में।
राहुल गांधी को जिन्हों पहनाकर आप दलित के साथ पास जा रहे हैं, there are millions of Dalits who are deprived from you.
They are Hindus. हिंदू धर्म में हर एक के लिए स्थान है, हिंदू के दिल में हर एक के लिए स्थान है। आप इसको संकीर्ण बनाए चले जा रहे हैं। आज मुसलमान के विरुद्ध, कल दलित के विरुद्ध, मोहन जी भागवत तो कहते हैं आरक्षण अभी समाप्त कर दीजिए।
पार्टी
प्रोफेसर विवेक कुमार, माय क्वेश्चन इज
फॉर इंडिया,
माय लास्ट क्वेश्चन इज दैट
यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड इंडिया।
इज द मेन स्ट्रीम ऑपोजिशन, एंड इवन दो यू आर स्केप्टिकल ऑफ दीज यंग लीडर्स एज वी सॉ इन गुजरात, are they going to become a little codependent with these young leaders as we go forward?
I think so, because actually the mainstream leadership doesn't have the narrative and the idiom in which they can really challenge the present dispensation. Because actually the mainstream politics itself has been discredited many times, and actually it has been again and again. So the young people are not, you know, accepting their vocabulary, their idioms, their narratives. And therefore, actually, the young people, they have a lot of energy, and they are coming with a very innovative energy as well as narrative. So you can really discard them saying that, look, they are divisive. But I don't think that. This is the way youth energy comes, because that's where the youth is all about.
Skeptical about whether it can last the long term.
That's what actually you have to channelize it with organization and ideology. If that is not there, if they go haywire, if they start actually taking any programs and any, you know, ideology, that is not going to last.
One we exception have seen here who's Assam. Been who's we shown seen, that he can do mass politics.
We have seen in Assam,
yeah.
We have seen Assam. In Assam, how the whole youth leadership came out of opposition. But what has happened there?
I think there that note of caution that you strike is very, very important. It's a fascinating conversation, actually. Thank you very much.